In this video, I'd like to show you how to manage the quality of your master data based on data quality rules in Master Data Governance Cloud Edition. Before opening the system, let's take a quick look at the process. You can evaluate the quality of your master data based on data quality rules that you define. You can schedule these evaluations and then analyze the evaluation results. As part of the analysis, you can identify areas of data with errors, potential reasons for data with errors, and you can initiate the correction. You can edit individual records using single requests, and you can create mass requests to edit multiple records. The process is complete once your request is approved. For this example, let's assume you are a master data steward and you want to analyze the general data of your business partner records and you want to carry out corrections for the records that need to be improved. You do this in the Evaluation Results app. The evaluation is based on rules. You can see the rules that are applied in the Data Quality Rules app. The list shows the individual rules that are in place. In this case, there are rules for bank data, address data, and general data referring to the search term and the title. To start your analysis, you launch the Evaluation Results app. On the tile, you can see the current number of errors found in the latest evaluation. The app shows the results of the most recent evaluation run, and you can use it to analyze your data quality rule evaluation results, for example, by determining why certain records contain errors. The initial screen shows the evaluation outcome for data quality rules that were applied to your business partner records, and it consists of three parts. There's the filter bar at the top where you can switch between records with or without errors, and there's a chart and a table view for the evaluation items. The result overview shows that 40 records contain errors, and of those, 30 person records are affected. The chart view refers to the base table, which is the database table the evaluation is based on, and you can use this view to drill down further. For example, to show a breakdown of errors by country or other business partner attributes. In this scenario, you want to correct the data for persons, so you select persons, and you want to correct the general business partner data, so you click on the corresponding bar to display only the errors that refer to general data. In the table that shows the results, you see all the affected business partner records that contain an error, as well as the rule that is violated. In the result list, you can open a quick view to see details of the individual business partner and of the rule. You can also click on the links in the evaluation items table if you want to navigate to the individual records. To edit the records and make corrections, you can process several or all items in a mass request. In this case, the same rule is violated by all data records and you decide to edit them all in a mass request. In the mass processing, you select Edit Records, and you can then select several or all items to edit them. Since the title is missing for all of these records, you edit them all and enter Mr. as the title. You can also edit individual records. In this case, one of the persons is a woman, so you edit this record individually and select Mrs. as the title. You save your changes and the mass request is now created in the workflow inbox of the next processor. The approver reviews the details and, if everything is okay, approves the mass request. You can now use the Schedule Data Quality Evaluation app to schedule an evaluation run for the business partner records. Once the evaluation has been carried out, the correction you made is reflected in the evaluation results. The business partner records you just changed are now correct and don't return an error anymore in the evaluation.